Welcome to this lecture on case studies on corrosion failures. My name is Dr. K. Ilayaperumal. I am a corrosion and metallurgical consultant. There are so many reasons for corrosion failures as given in this layout. Deficiencies in any of these factors like design, fabrication, MOC, that means material of construction, metal quality, the process control, process impurities, process treatment, any deficiency in any of these aspects would lead to corrosion failures. In this case study, we will talk about premature cracking of stainless steel heat exchanger tubes in a pulp and paper plant. A pulp and paper plant processes pulp, and then from the thickened pulp, papers are produced. The first equipment in any pulp and paper plant is the pulp digester. This is a schematic of pulp digester. Wood chips are charged into the digester, and the digester will have some kind of a caustic solution at a high temperature, which will digest the wood chips, and then the resultant product is called pulp, and the pulp is further processed. To maintain the temperature, there is a reboiler. The reboiler position and the bottom of the digester are shown schematically on this. The purpose of reboiler is to reheat the liquid and then send back to the digester. So this heating is done by either steam or some thermic fluid which circulates on the shell side and giving the heat to the pulp liquid, which goes into the tubes. These tubes in this case are made by 316 stainless steel, which is a typical austenitic stainless steel containing about 18% chromium, 8% nickel, about 2 to 3% molybdenum, and this is known for its general good corrosion resistance. In this case, these tubes of 316SS failed in a short period, relatively short period of 8 years. The failure occurred through a circumferential crack on position midway between two baffles which are located within the heat exchanger to position the tubes. The service life, I repeat, it's 8 years. After 8 years, they decided to change the tubes. The changed tubes are shown in this lower portion of the slide. You can see the changed tube. Unfortunately, the changed tube gave very, very low service period. In about 6 months, cracks have occurred in several portions of the tubes, resulting in leakage. You can see the crack here. And under the same service condition, they have not changed the service condition. So this is a very unexpected premature failure for stainless steel tube to crack in 6 months, whereas a similar stainless steel tube performed for 8 years earlier. In both cases, the cracks were in between two baffles on the mid position of the baffles. This is a cross section of the crack. This is done by utilizing optical microscope, and this is called optical micrograph. What you are seeing is a cross section of a cracked tube, and this surface corresponds to the inside of surface of the tube. You can see cracks developing and progressing towards outside of the tube across the wall. This is called multiple branched cracks initiating the inside surface of the tubes. This is called the liquor side. Inside means liquor side, because there the processed liquor is in contact, whereas on the outside of the tube, steam is in contact. So this is how the cracks are occurred. And this is typical of caustic stress corrosion cracking. Any cracking due to mechanical force will have only one crack. This will not have multiple initiation. So multiple branched cracks means it is stress corrosion cracking. In this case, it is caused by caustic of the mother liquor. And this is the reboiler heat exchanger service conditions. Let us look at the service conditions. This is the pulp liquor which is being processed in the digester. A typical composition is sodium hydroxide 76 gram per liter, sodium sulfide 12 gram per liter, sodium carbonate 18 gram per liter, and usually the balance is only water. This is an aqueous caustic solution of very high pH. The operating temperature, the outlet temperature, that means the temperature required for digesting operation is 170 degrees centigrade. So this, the white liquor comes in here at a lower temperature, gets heated up and goes back to the digester at this temperature. This is the tube side condition. This is the typical caustic environment because it contains high concentration of sodium hydroxide. Even the other two also caustic producing chemical. The shell side, the steam under positive pressure of 7 kg per centimeter squared, it flows inside and it gives away the heat to the white liquor. So this is the service condition. And we should not forget the tubes are made of type 316 SS stainless steel. This is a well-published literature showing service limits curves for caustic cracking of both carbon steel and also stainless steel. What this gives is a plot of temperature either in degree centigrade or in degree Fahrenheit as a function of caustic concentration and showing the boundary limits. Below the limit, there is no stress corrosion cracking, and above the limit, there is a stress corrosion cracking of stainless steel. So if you apply this to our present condition, you will see our concentration is about 25-30% caustic concentration, and the temperature is about 170 degrees, and the meeting point is well within the stress corrosion cracking region. So the observed problem is caustic stress corrosion cracking. Service conditions lie well within the stress corrosion region for stainless steel. So this is a very strong evidence to show that the operating conditions have led to caustic stress corrosion cracking. Now, this is a big question. Why? Because the earlier batch gave 8 years of service. A replacement batch gave only 6 months of service. Why? You can see again, the samples are shown here. 8 years for old one and 6 months for a new one. We will try to find out the answer for this question. Why? You can compare here the chemical analysis of old tube and the new replaced tube. See the basic difference, any 316 SS should have molybdenum. So this is why all other elements are not shown. This is the typical molybdenum content. This shows it is a part of 316. The major difference, the old one has got 0.68% carbon, whereas a new one is 0.027% carbon. So anything less than 0.3% carbon is called the L variety, and this is 316LSS, and the old one is 316SS, where the carbon content normally says around 0.08% maximum. So this corresponds to 316. So this is the major difference between the old tubes and the new tubes. Incidentally, 316LSS is more expensive than 316SS because of reduced carbon content. You can see, in addition to chemical composition, you can see mechanical properties, and 316 is about 37 kg per mm squared yield strength, whereas 316L are only 29.5, around 30 kg per mm squared. There is it's about 20-25% difference lower 316L in mechanical strength. You can see 316LSS is mechanically weaker than 316SS. I post a poll in LinkedIn to assess the public opinion regarding the diagnosis for this particular case without disclosing the details. I have given four alternatives. The result is shown in this slide. One can notice that the majority opted for wrong material of construction selection. My own diagnosis will be shown in the next slide. So now the diagnosis is caustic stress corrosion cracking of both old and new tubes. Conditions for stress corrosion cracking: there must be a presence of tensile stress, and this is contributed by the vibration between baffles. The baffles are supporting plates within the shell, and the tubes are inserted. So if the tubes are slightly moving between the baffles, there is a likelihood of tensile stress coming in. And the another condition for stress corrosion cracking: there must be an environment like chloride, like caustic, like carbonate, etc. In this case, the caustic solution. And there must be a sufficient temperature for this phenomenon to occur. So in the present case, 170 degree is the bulk temperature. And the material should be susceptible for stress corrosion cracking. In this case, both 316SS and 316LSS, both are austenitic stainless steel, and both are susceptible to stress corrosion cracking by caustic. Comparison of material: the 316L, which gave shorter life because of lower strength. We have seen this in the mechanical properties table. For a given stress induced by vibration, 316L being weaker, it will fail quicker than 316, which is stronger. So 316L is developed for some other reason, but it is not expected to resist caustic stress corrosion cracking. This point was not given its due appreciation when choosing the MOC. So conclusion: this case is due to wrong MOC choice during replacement, and that has resulted into this premature problem. This is the final diagnosis. Incidentally, because of low carbon for 316L, 316L is more expensive. In general, we should not assume that 316L or any other more expensive material does not mean it is resistant to specific corrosion problem. So more expensive does not mean better performance. This condition varies from situation to situation. Recommendation for avoiding this problem is, since 316SS has given at least 10 years of service, you continue with 316SS instead of changing to 316LSS. That is one possibility, one recommendation. The other recommendation is, explore the possibility of reducing stress by redesigning the baffle position, because this will reduce the vibrationary stress. and reducing the service temperature. If the process people allow you, you reduce the service temperature, because the slightly lower temperature will bring the condition below the stress corrosion cracking curve. Longer life, choose an MOC material of construction better than 316, like duplex stainless steel or nickel base alloy. So these are the three types of recommendations given for this case study. The key takeaway in this case study is we have seen stainless steel cracking by the phenomenon called caustic stress corrosion cracking, and this problem is occurred because of a wrong MOC choice for replacement. So this is a case study of a wrong MOC selection. Thank you very much. And this book called Corrosion Failures has been written by Professor Raja of IIT Mumbai and me. And this book gives details about various corrosion failures and their backgrounds. And this book is available through Amazon. Thank you again.